Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Bless you. Bless you. I pray that you guys are having a brilliant start of your morning. It is such a beautiful day. It's a little crisp here in the Northeast, but it's a beautiful day nonetheless. It is, the Word of God says, this is the day the Lord has made and we shall rejoice. What's going on, Lee? How you doing? I just wanted to say good morning to each of you and really to talk to you all just for a second. So I'm gonna wait about 30 seconds for others to jump on in before we get started. But if it's just you and I, Lee, then hey, that's more than enough. For God says where two or three are gathered in my midst, He says I'm in the middle of it. And so we thank God for that. Amen. And so just going to wait about 20 more seconds. And then we're going to begin. Amen. Such a beautiful day. Right now the car says it's 51 degrees. Hey, Julia, God bless you. It says it's 51 degrees. And those who know me know that I like cooler weather more than I like hotter weather. Because some of the things I do, you know, it's more difficult when the weather is hot. Like, for example, fishing. Fishing is better when it's a little bit cooler and not too hot. Camping, for me, is better when it's in the winter than it's in the summer. Biking, all the things that I do on the outdoors is better. And, you know, it's better for me. But anyway, let me talk to you just for a few minutes. I want to remind you, last night I taught on a class about the stretch. And if you did not see that, I would pray that you would take the opportunity to look at that. It was less than an hour long. And I believe that it would be advantageous for you and each of us to really apply those things to our hearts. You know, the Word of God says that if we're hearers only, but not doers, we deceive ourselves. And, you know, the fact of the matter is the Word comes that we might have life. You know, it comes that we might experience something better than what we're experiencing now. Hey, Wendy, how you doing, sis? And so, you know, I talked about the stretch, right? And so this morning, I want to ask you, for those of you who watched the class last night, did you get up this morning stretching? Did you get up this morning stretching? Not only stretching your natural body, but also stretching your spiritual body. Did you get up this morning stretching? One of the things I want to encourage you, and a lot of people don't really know this. If you ever notice, right, let's say, for example, if you want to grow in Christ, you know, you have some issues in your life and you want to grow in Christ and you're like, God, I want these issues to change. I want to experience better things in my life. You know, God, help me, right? What's interesting is that a lot of people don't recognize that when you, let's say, for example, you know, you start studying the Word of God, right? And you say, well, you know, I'm going to spend a little more time in prayer. I'm going to spend a little more time in worship. I'm going to spend a little more time in study and meditation in the Word of God, right? It's like all of a sudden, all of these problems pop out. Have you guys ever noticed that? Have you ever noticed that? Hold on, I got to put on my shades. It's really, really, really bright. Have you ever noticed that, you know, that when you desire to do something in the right way, that it's like things become so chaotic, right? You know, maybe you might find more weaknesses in you. You know, you might find more opportunities of failure and things that have happened in your life. You know, a lot of people get discouraged because, you know, they, you know, like, for example, when a person comes to the church, you know, or hears a sermon or hears a teaching and they go, wow, you know, I like that teaching, you know, and then when they get up the next day, you know, challenges come and situations of life happens, and then that person becomes discouraged. That person becomes discouraged because they end up saying, oh man, I failed again. Oh man, I messed up again. Or maybe this morning with Pastor Rodney saying, hey, did you get up this morning and stretch? And you're like, oh man, I left the house. You know, yesterday I was doing some work and I had one of the members of my church with me, and we went to pick up a little bite to eat after we had finished working. And when we picked up a little bite to eat, and they, you know, we were both hungry, and they bit into their salmon and said, oh my God, I forgot to pray. And I started joking. I was like, Lord, don't kill them, Lord, right? And my point is that sometimes we could get so caught up in the things that we're doing until we forget, right, what we should do, right? And sometimes, like even in teaching, you can learn something and then the very next day you can forget. Or you can learn something and then you can try to your best to do it, but then it seems like things come out that is just like negative, or things that come out that are discouraging, right? I want to tell you why that happens. Why does that happen, right? Because the Word of God says that the enemy, he comes to snatch the word from you. He comes to snatch the thing from you that is good for you, the things that is advantageous for you, right? He, you know, when God dips something into your spirit or when something happens in your life, the enemy, his desire is to steal, to kill, and to destroy, right? And so he wants to take away from you that joy. He wants to take away from you that peace. He wants to take away from you that focus and that mindset. Why? Because if he could just discourage you, then you'll be your own worst enemy, because you'll decide to quit. You'll decide to give up and give in. So it's almost like if you have a dirty cup, right? If you have a dirty cup and there's dirt all inside the cup, and you decide, okay, I'm gonna pour water, clean water into this cup. When you pour that clean water into this cup, the first thing that comes out of the cup is dirty water, right? And a lot of people don't really think about that. It's the same thing with your heart. If you've been doing the wrong thing for so long, or you've been following wrong practices, or you've been living in a way that you shouldn't live, when you decide to do the right thing, that's like that pouring that water in, that clean water in, and the first thing that comes out is the dirt. So yeah, don't be shocked. The Word of God says, think it not strange concerning the fiery trials that is to try you, as though something strange happened to you. No, don't think about, you know, that this strange, this is strange, this is weird. Why am I feeling this way? Why, I'm trying to break the lust in me, and why all of a sudden am I feeling more lustful? I'm trying to change the way I talk, and now people are just getting on my nerve and I want to say something, right? That's because the word is going in you and it's dredging out the bottom of your heart, and that wickedness and the stuff that was inside, embedded inside, is floating to the top. Right? And so what do we have to say about that? The Word of God says, be not weary in well doing. Don't be weary. Don't be weary in well doing. Because you're gonna reap if you don't quit, if you don't faint. You're gonna make it through if you don't quit, right? And today we have a lot of people that are so accustomed to quitting. A lot of people that are so accustomed to, well, it's a little bit too hard right now, so I'm gonna stop. It's a little bit too hard right now. I'm going through too much right now, so I'm going to stop. I'm not going to do anymore. I'm not going to say anymore. I'm not going to try anymore, because every time I try, I seem to fail, right? I'm telling you, don't quit. Don't quit. Don't give in. Don't give up. You're going to get through. You're going to get through it. You're going to come out on the other side. You're going to be better for it, right? Keep pushing. It doesn't matter if nobody doesn't encourage you. Doesn't matter if no one sees the little integral or baby steps that you're making. Nobody sees the little steps that you're making in the right direction. And maybe they may spend more time criticizing you in the wrong direction. You know, they speak more about the things they see about that you don't have, but they don't speak about the little steps that you make. Look, don't be discouraged. Don't be discouraged. Believe me, I've been there. Right? I've been there. And even now in my life where I'm still trying to grow, there are times that I still get discouragement. There are times that I still get frustrated. And there are times that I still get negativity from people that you know, shouldn't do it. You know, they should be encouraging, but instead they are discouraging. I'm telling you, don't quit, right? And that's why we're going to continue in this mindset of the stretch. We're going to continue in the stretch. We're going to keep stretching. We're going to keep forgetting those things that are behind us. We're going to keep pressing. We're going to keep reaching, right? We're going to keep desiring and longing for more, right? Let that desire continually grow in your life. For the Bible says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst after righteousness. Why? Because they shall be filled, right? So it doesn't matter, you know, what you're going through. It doesn't matter all the challenges that you're going through. Know this, that the race is not given to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, but every prize is given to the one that endures. You got to be able to endure to the end. You got to be able to hang in there. You know, perseverance, that's a part. Long suffering is a part of the fruit of the Spirit, right? So you got to be able to persevere past the pain. And I know we live in a very discouraging time. We live in a time where there's so many things that we could be frustrated about. But listen, don't let that be your mantra. Don't let that be your modus operandi. Don't let that be your focus or your theme of the day. Don't let that filter and translate to what kind of day you're going to have. David said, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. So that means you got to take the time to look at your day, look at your circumstances, figure out what you need to figure out. Don't get stressed out. Don't get worried. You know, if you got people supporting you, praise God. If you got people discouraging you, praise God. Why? Because in everything, we got to give thanks. Keep stretching. Keep pushing. You're going to make it through. You're going to make it through. And when you come out on the other side, guess what? All of this stress and all of the trials and all of the difficulties that you went through, all the denial and all of the friends that turned their backs on you, all these things, listen, I'm not like the world. And a lot of people in the world, they talk about, oh, when they see you, then they're going to be jealous of why they didn't stick with you. No, that's not even the Spirit of God. What I'm saying to you is that if you push and you keep going through the pain, through the trouble, then guess what? At the end of it all, you're going to be stronger because of it. Your faith is going to be more firm. You're going to have more gravity, more maturity. You're going to have more discipline, right? And then guess what? God may call you, because God is a God of love. He may call you to turn back to those same people, to help them get up out of their mess, right? To help them get out of their confusion, to help them get out of their weaknesses. So you be strong. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Keep going forward. That's what I want to really impress upon you in the stretch. Keep going forward. Don't worry about who's not around. Don't worry about who's not connecting. Don't worry about who forgot about you. Don't worry about that. You are not forgotten. You are not forgotten, right? And don't play the guilt trip on people. When people connect with you and say, I haven't heard from you in a long, don't play. You know, just keep moving. Keep doing everything that you're supposed to do. Why? Because we're stretching. We're reaching. We're pressing towards the mark of the mark of the prize of the high calling, which is in Christ Jesus. We are pressing, right? And because we are pressing, we ain't got time for the pain. We ain't got time for the silliness. We ain't got time for the back and forth. We ain't got time for that stuff. We have to be about our Father's business. And so, you know, don't worry about if while you're trying to do good, don't worry about if while you're trying to do the right thing, all of a sudden you feel more bad stuff is coming out of you. No, keep pouring it in, because eventually if you keep pouring that water in that glass will be clean, because that water will dredge out everything that's in that glass, even in the nooks and crannies. It'll dredge it out. And you'll be clean. After a while, you'll be clean. And then you'll realize that all of this time that you spent was worth it. It was worth it. It was worth it. It was worth it. It was worth it. You know, be not weary in well-doing, for you shall reap if you faint not. You're going to reap. You're going to get through it. You're going to get through it if you don't faint. You're going to get through it if you don't faint. I'm going to say that again. I don't know. I feel this strongly in my spirit because some of you have this quit spirit. Some of you are going through things where you're getting frustrated and getting aggravated. And come on, you say, oh, Pastor, I'm not getting aggravated. Well, yes, you are, because you're complaining. Yes, you are. You're complaining. You're complaining in your thoughts. You're complaining in your conversation. You're complaining all those things. And guess what? That's a sign that these things are frustrating to you, that these things are stressful to you. And as believers, we can't be so flaky thin. We got to be able to take something. We got to be able to go through something. So I just wanted to encourage you this morning as I'm on my way to work. It's been a very for me. At the same time of trying to grow in myself and really seek God like I've never done before. And, you know, it's been a lot of weights on my shoulders, you know, but I'm not discouraged. You know, I'm just really continuing on in God. And I see the rainbow, you know, I see the lightness. I see the light. I see the beauty of God, even in the midst of, everything that I'm going through. I see his beauty, you know, and that's why, you know, if you think about it, look at Elijah Isaiah in Isaiah chapter 6, where he saw the Lord high and lifted up, and his glory, his train filled the temple, you know, and all he could say is, woe is me, I am undone. I'm a man of unclean lips, and I dwell amongst people of unclean lips. And that's where I am. It's just really. And so I just want to encourage you today. Hold on.